Warning, these countdowns are based on Cloud8745's personal opinions. Understand that everyone has their own opinions. If you would like to, make your own countdown as a response to this video, and I shall view it as well. Enjoy this countdown. At number 10, The Legend of Zelda, Twilight Princess on the GameCube and the Wii. This game is where a lot of people say the game finally became darker. I disagree, seeing as Majora's Mask is incredibly dark, but anyways. In this game, Link can become a wolf with the help of Minda, and while being a wolf, there are sections you need to kill these, light bugs, which is honestly is my least favorite part of the game. Didn't really enjoy it that much. The game has some items I do like, though, such as the, top item, which I felt was incredibly underused, but that's honestly just because I like it. And some nice little returning enemies. There's, look at that little Helmasaur right there. Look at him. Anyways, the game has an amazing soundtrack and a great story. I do like the addition of the horseback riding fights, aka being able to use your sword while riding your horse instead of just the bow and arrow and etc. like in the past games. I also do think the final fight was awesome, even though some people disagree with me, but whatever. I think it was really well done. I mean, hey, you don't need to push that one button to make things easier. At number 9. The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening DX for the Game Boy Color, and Game Boy you could say. The DX version added a new dungeon, a color-based dungeon which gives you a pretty powerful reward depending on which you choose. Both are great, but honestly, make the game a little too easy, so I don't usually grab it that quick. One thing I did not like about the game is when you pick up the acorns, the compass, and the triangle of power, basically, there's a message that lasts a while, and the music was pretty annoying, but that's not the point. The game is great, and I do like the story, but man, that ending, when you think about it, it's pretty dark. Think about it. I find it funny you could steal items in the shop, which gets you killed and basically ruins your save file by changing your name to Thief for the remainder of the game. Remember, kids, stealing is bad. The game also has some funny glitches and stuff, but most games do, I guess, so it's not all that special, huh? Well, I like it, so whatever. Nah. At number 8, The Legend of Zelda Oracle of Seasons and The Legend of Zelda Oracle of Ages. I am tying these because they share some of the same elements, like the rings and whatnot, and the fact, to fight the true final boss, you need to actually play through both games, which I think is pretty neat. Seasons revolves around the four seasons being under chaos, while Ages is all about time being under chaos. Both games have different story, different bosses, and even different overworlds. I would recommend for those who have not played these, buy these on the 3DS eShop, along with Link's Awakening if you haven't also. I have never fully beat Ages, but I'm actually playing it now. I grew up with Seasons though, and I love it. I really do love Seasons. I love the throwbacks to other older Legend of Zelda games and whatnot, and I really do like the ring system, and if I'm not mistaken, I think you could carry over your rings right to the other game and whatnot, but seriously, if you have not played Ages and Seasons, please play both and fight the true final boss. You won't regret it. Both are definitely great games. At number 7, Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link. Now I know some people are gonna be like, oh, that game's bad, and I'll be like, why is it bad? And they're usually like, cause it's different, and it's hard. Yes, I like this game because it's different, and honestly, it's not that hard once you get accustomed to it, to the controls and whatnot. I recently did a walkthrough, which probably isn't up anymore for my knowledge, and I basically devastated the game. I didn't get a game over till sometime after Death Mountain, but a lot of people complain that the game's too hard, but the thing is, you need to give yourself some time to learn. Yes, there's a level up system in this game, but you don't have to go full out grind, unless you, of course, keep dying, then I guess you might have to a little bit. But practice this game, and I'm pretty sure you'll grow to like it a lot more. There are a lot worse NES games out there, so people need to give this game more of a shot. Zelda 2 is definitely better than most people make it, well, than they make it seem to be. So please, for me, if you haven't played it, give it a shot. Learn. It's an NES game. At number 6, The Legend of Zelda, Wind Waker. This game, of course, for the GameCube. This is like one of the harder games to 100% for me. If you have, you know, with all the pictograph or whatever stuff. I really like in this game Link's facial expressions, his eyes and whatnot. And the cel-shaded graphics, they're great. Like, a lot of people don't like cel-shaded graphics for some reason. I think it's refreshing. It's really nice to look at and whatnot, and I'm happy they're going to be doing a remake of this game in HD, basically, on the Wii U. So if you haven't played this on the GameCube and you own a Wii U or are going to get one in the future, remember to pick up the HD remake or whatnot of this game, and hopefully you like it. Some people complain about the C segments being long and boring, but at least there's somewhere to go and whatnot. I like that. The music for the C sections is great, and I like being able to explore it and go to all the islands and get my C charts and whatnot. So you know what, people? No! At number 5, the original Legend of Zelda on the NES. This game is basically just super duper historical. This game is a legend, and because of this game, I mean, it shaped the way a lot of games are nowadays. And of course, it's super duper classic, and it's hard, it's pretty difficult. I really like the fact that Nintendo took the time and effort to basically even put in a second quest in this game. For when you beat it, or just put your name as Zelda basically, you're able to do a much harder second quest where the dungeons are pretty brutal and unforgiving, and it's pretty hard to figure all of it out without a strategy guide. Especially if you're like a kid growing up and you really are like, whoa, this is my first Legend of Zelda game. For those that haven't played it, like, once again, and like, oh, it's too difficult, give it a try. The game's great. Yeah, you could, pretty sure you can still get it on some of the virtual console stuff, right? Right? Probably the Wii one. But if you ever get a chance, pick it up. If you haven't played it, it's great. It's definitely fun, takes time, and have fun exploring, basically, because that's what a lot of NES games are about. At number 4, The Legend of Zelda, Majora's Mask. This is a dark game. People talk about dark Legend of Zelda games. People want to talk about Twilight Princess. This game basically is about death. This game is about sadness and collecting masks. I mean, this whole game is basically surrounded. The story is about basically the apocalypse of Clock Town, or the world if you want to really go about that. The moon is going to fall and you need to stop it from falling. And there's so much emotion in this game. There's so many things, especially in the final hours. If you go around town, see people, the Anju and Cafe quest, the swordsman guy, the trainer guy, if you talk to him, you can find him like cowering in fear. Yes, this game is incredibly dark, but this game is also side quest heavy. This game has amazing side quests and whatnot. The main story falls a bit short in terms of how long it is. That's really the only reason it's at its place right now. I wish the main story was a little longer. The side quests, though, are amazing. The game is amazing. But at number 3, The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. This game is higher than Majora's Mask simply because of the main quest, and I simply like it more, of course. I also enjoy glitching and speedrunning this game more, so oh well. But I love both games so much. Don't get me wrong, I love side quests and all, and Majora's Mask is the king of that. But the main story of OOT is very important in terms of the Legend of Zelda lore with the introduction of Ganondorf. Sure, the game has its side stuff like the Gold Skull Duels and whatnot. This game does have more dungeons and whatnot in terms of the main story, but it does have easier bosses. Ken always has more, whatever, than Majora. But anyways, it also has my favorite Ganon battle of all time. It's fucking epic, and I hope one day they can top it. The 3DS version of the game is also amazing. If you're a big fan of OOT and not played it, get it. The 3D is amazing. Along with, well, everything. The models and everything updated looks fantastic, and I hope Majora's Mask gets a 3DS version one day as well. Imagine the moon in 3D. At number 2, The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. This one will come as a surprise to some people, except those on my stream. I really don't understand the hate this game gets at all. The game controls are flawless, and it's not the game's fault your sensor bar is set up wrong, or your arms are flailing around like mad. The story for Skyward Sword is amazing, and of course the soundtrack is amazing. It's basically the first Legend of Zelda in terms of the timeline, and it fits up there perfectly. Even more so if you read the manga/comic of it in the Hyrule Historia, and it explains a lot of things perfectly. The only thing I wish they did better was the flying segments. There's not enough places to fly to. In Wind Waker, people complained the ocean was far too big. Now the sky is far too small and does not have enough in it. Hopefully, Nintendo could find the medium basically for this and make people happy by the next game. I just really do like Skyward Sword a lot. Has a few like fun side stuff. Has a great main story. A really great meaty story. So, go play it! And now, before number 1, let's go over a recap. At number 10, The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. At number 9, The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening DX. At number 8, The Legend of Zelda Oracle of Ages and Seasons. At number 7, Zelda 2, The Adventures of Link. At number 6, The Legend of Zelda, Wind Waker. At number 5, The Original Legend of Zelda. And number 4, The Legend of Zelda, Majora's Mask. And number 3, The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time. And in number 2, The Legend of Zelda, Skyward Sword. And finally, at number 1, The Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past for the SNES. God, I love this game. This game to me is basically perfect, and I don't say that for many games. It has great dungeons, it has great and challenging bosses, which it does, bosses such as Almasaur King and Blind and whatnot. I love the dungeon design, and the overworld is one of my favorites. I can't wait for Link to the Past 2. I'm really, really hoping they do Link to the Past 2 correctly, and I'm sure they will. I'm watching, Nintendo. I'm watching. Anyways, like I said, this game overall is my favorite. It has my favorite overworld, has great dungeons and bosses, great overall, makes for a fun time. So if you, for some reason, have not played this yet, please go. Please go and buy it. Buy a physical copy. Buy it on the eShop. Play the GBA version, I don't care. But just find it, buy it, and enjoy it. Enjoy it, or I will find you. Enjoy it! Now anyways, I hope everyone enjoyed the countdown. Please make your own countdown as a response to this video so I can see your own personal opinions. I do like watching people's countdowns besides my own, so it would be nice to see what your favorite top 10 Legend of Zelda games are, you know, compared to mine, and why, of course, they're your favorite. Because, like I said, this is a countdown based on my personal opinions, so everyone has their different ones, so don't hate for that. So, if you have time, I'd like to see yours. Bye-bye.